not the best way to get them into Condor. I would say. Because we need something that's. Yeah, the objects are accepted as well from SketchUp, but sometimes it feels like SketchUp doesn't know what itself is doing. And then the objects can mess up very fast. Yes, if you want to see it in Wings, we can have a look. So just do it for one object now. We will. Okay. Yes, very good. I would split it up if you can do it right here. That would be nice. Can you ungroup it somehow? Okay, then please do it. Yeah, exactly, explode. And right now, export it to an OBJ file. We can better see it in Wings 3D. Okay. So cool. No, that's fine. As you just rotated it correctly in SketchUp, it should be fine right here. Yeah. That is looking quite good, okay. But as I told. As I told, been last night or the last days, you see the issue which comes up from SketchUp on the right side right now. You have the outliner, and there you can see the materials and used textures or images. And right now, this is actually one object at least, and it has 6, 7, 8, 9, 5, 10, about 15 textures and 20 materials. For actually one object, you can only use one texture and one material. It's important to understand because you can't just this face right here is one face and then put the texture on it and then put it to one object at the end, and that doesn't work. And Condor, not for any other building. So, we shortly need the geometry graph on the right side as well. Go to Window. Then geometry graph, yes. And you can move it from here into this position. Then it's, yes, like this. Fine. So, What's good to understand in Wings are these four options on the top right here. You have the, that's about your selection, okay? So if you want to select something in here, you need to first think about what you want to select. Will you want to select the role object, which includes then this role object right here? Or will you only select a face, of course, or an edge, or a vertice? You know the difference, of course, I would. Very good. Okay. So, yeah, right now we have one object right here, mesh one, and all these materials and all these textures. That will not work on Condor, as I just said. So if you still want to use this house, we at least need to do a remapping of it. And hope it works then. First, go one time to object mode and select the object, yes. And press a right click and make separate. And see if it separates into more objects. Yes. See, right now we have these 7 or 8 objects. Try to see only one object right now and what we have right there. Click on the eye close to the mesh and do it for the others as well. And only go for one first object. Yes, stop. Okay. yeah. That's what I wanted to say about SketchUp. Creates objects that are, well, I would say not needed. Yes, that's right. I think we can still use this, maybe. We can try, but I'm not sure if it works in Condor then, but let's see. Okay, turn on the objects again, one by one, to see what... Okay. Yeah, go for a combine as again, select all objects. Combine them. Yes. Now go for a right click and select UV mapping, but hover the mouse above it and you can see what the left and middle bars are doing. Generate UV mapping or texture with the left mouse button. You can do it as well, but with the right mouse button it forces every object and delete the old ones. As we don't want to need the old ones again, go for a right click right here. So then it overrides everything from before. So now the UV mapping thing window opens. You can do the same like in the geometry window as well. You can zoom out or rotate the mouse. Yes. Right now, with your mouse scroll wheel. Yes. Yeah, if you want to move the camera, you can rather go for your arrow keys. It goes right, right and left. Or if you want to, I've told this Finn as well yesterday, you want to set the center of your camera, you can select or hover above a face, go for this one here. Oh. Hover your mouse above a face. You mean to the right or left or? Okay, then do with the middle mouse, click on it. Yes, and right now press A on your keyboard and the center of your camera moves right there. Okay? That's important. That are the most important things to know. Press X on your keyboard. Press Y on your keyboard. Y. Yes. Yes, exactly. And you can press Shift Z and Shift X and Shift Y to see the opposite direction then. Okay. That's very important to get a yeah. It's important to know. So basically what we need to do in the UV mapping right now. Oh yeah, just a second. Maybe it's quite oh yeah. So it should be a little bit better now. Okay, no problem. So yeah, right now for the UV mapping we need to select the edges that cut our object into faces at least. Like the edges you select right now are cutting the objects up into the faces you want to put a texture on. It's a little bit hard to say it right here, but if you for example want to have this face with a texture on, then right now click into edge mode, then the edges around this face are selected and make a right click now. You can go every outside, it's no problem. Then mark edges for cut. Now deselect by pressing spacebar. You see the User yellow lines around it. So what would happen right now? We would have this face right here. Yeah, the rest, the texture would then be projected not on this face, not on this face. Hard to explain, you can better do it by seeing then. But what we need to do is to select the roll edges around this object. Like this one, this one, this one, this one, so on. I think yes. What I think is more easy right here, you can select the roll object, yes, with the face mode. Right now deselect just the roll building. Yes, and now go into edge mode again. Then make mark edges for cut. Yes, deselect, and now you maybe need to adjust it a little bit by spacebar. You can take the spacebar. Now maybe this one don't need a cut. Yes, exactly. Same on the other side. Rotate the camera a little bit. Yep. Exactly. Yes, exactly. Go for a right click now and then press unmark edges. Select again. Yes, can you find any other edges that are not used? Because what we will do is to do a normal projection. So the camera of the projection camera will then look into the normal of your building. You will see it later when we do it. More easy to understand. But I see a few edges we don't need. Can you find them? These two, you are completely right. Going to maybe deselect again. You only want to select the two edges right there. We only want to deselect these two. Now go into edge mode. Exactly. Ah, no, don't delete this one. Delete the one on lower. Yes. That is fine. Right click, mark. Very good. Same on the other four edges. Yes, press space bar right now. And they are not marked. Very good. Very good. Yes, I see two more edges we don't need. Right here, the other side. That's up to you. We have like this face then, which goes around here and around the wall object. And then this side. Or you can have it as one object, that wouldn't be a problem because you won't see it anyway in Gondori bottom side. Yes. Yeah. Think maybe we run into a SketchUp issue right there. Because I don't know how the top is done right now. But if you have like a normal closed mesh or normal object, you can detect them without any problem. Yes. That's the problem, right? But okay, we can go for it like this right now and see if it works. Go for a right click right now. So if you are done with all markings of your object, right click just without selecting anything. Press continue. Then make projection normal. That's what we get from the hangar. You see what we did right now? Yes. Exactly. And now we have the faces separately on one texture. Right now this is something which is, I would say, important. Which happens right now because as we have not full HD and 4K textures, we need to use the space on our texture as good as possible. Yes, you first need to scale or rotate or move them to fill just the whole texture. That would Yeah. You can just, if you want, you can leave it like this, but you waste like one of three of your texture file. So what I do right here, that's one of the most longest things you do while creating a plane. Because you have so many faces right there. Scale.
Er det bedre nu? Ah, okay. Ben, if we save this lot of small parts of building to bitmap files and in bitmap painted, and will this small parts come to the right place? Anyway, we have nothing in this situation we have now.
Yes, you can leave it like this if you want.
Yes, I think it's so big, complicated, and move all this to new place. Maybe we can take one or two at scalate to bigger, but lot of them can you be stay in the sites they have now. I can see at the smaller one in. Left in this corner it go out, but maybe we take only this and put up to this area so we not are outside of the square.
Yes, what I normally suggest, or just to show it suggested to Tim as well, is to use the whole space of the texture, because what you have right here right now on this face, you have a face that is 4 meters or something, and it's very tiny on the texture, so later you only have maybe 15 pixels for this space, and you use this space right here, it's not used.
No, I know
the texture.
But if we take this and this and this and at scale to bigger area and take this and turn round so it 90 degrees.
Yes.
And so I think that at all the other can we stay and put this picture in so it is coming up in
yes.
The building.
Absolute. That's just up to you.
Yeah.
You can of course leave it like this if you want to go fast and quick and dirty.
Yeah, I understand. Yeah.
Yes. So as Chris suggested, that's a good idea, I think. Do these two somewhere here and scale them up. These two scale them up that they fit into this space. And move this maybe up here, then you are good to go, I would say. Yes. Yes. Maybe scale down a little bit again.
Yeah, to smaller.
Yes, like this, beautiful. So that is something very important. You want to do better objects or deselect the other one. Yes. Press space again to deselect and then select new. Yes. That's something important to understand, that you need to use the whole space you've got. The planes, that's sometimes very hard because you do all the mapping and mapping and then forget about two or three objects and they need space. But you don't have space. Yes, I would move this on top here and then move these two down right here. What is important as well to keep in mind which face is which side, because later in Photoshop you only see these.
No, you must. Du skal lige trykke på mellemrumstasten på den øverste sådan der.
But if you get it in, you will use space for deselect and every other object as well, program as well. In 3ds Max, space is lock the object. I jumped into 3ds Max back the days and I was always locking every kind of object and I was wondering why I can't select them anymore. Press shift, you can go for a 90 degrees or 15 degrees turn. Just press shift right now, yes. Okay, I see you've got it. But it is a little bit of a problem right now. The faces on the left side are so close together that you need to be very precise in the Photoshop later. I would probably select the faces right here.
Yeah, but in Photoshop we can handle of the very short. It's no problem, I think so.
Yes. But it's very close, you will see it later in Photoshop,
yeah, yeah,
that
yeah,
it's
yeah.
Not that
it's
easy
no,
to exactly
no
match this point. Yeah, I would select the wall faces right here and just scale them by little amount. yes. When zoom
det
in,
fordi
the scroll right.
Der de ligger helt tæt.
Yes, I would go for the others as well.
No, it's free.
You can leave it,
well,
yes,
yeah.
It's okay. You can select all them by once, so this, click on this as well here. This as well.
You can take many and scale it in
yes.
The same time.
Yeah. That looks better. Even if you waste some space right now, but it's better to have a little bit of space between them.
Yeah.
Same for these two, I would go, and then we'll go at. That's beautiful.
Yeah, nice.
Okay.
This part here, you must also escalate like a little down.
Base is your best friend. You should probably buy a new just keys after using wings a lot because space buys.
Yeah. I hope so.
damage then.
and this part here, you must also escalate a little smaller.
Yes, that's right. Good.
Because it, I think it will go to the small one. Nice.
Exactly like this. Now we only waste like this space right here, and it's okay, a little bit here, but it's fine how it is right now.
Yeah.
Yeah, if we want to get a texture from this, then go for a right click somewhere, I don't know, wherever you like. Create texture. Now you can define the size of it.
I think it must be in 1024.
Yep, it depends on the size of your building, I would say. If you have like a bigger one, which is 20, 30, 40 meters big, I would go for 1024. If you have like a small, little one, only 3 or 4 meters, then go for 512. But that's up to you. Right here, go for the options. Can see you can select an image as background or a color. Right now we of course want a white back color. Yes. Okay, and on draw edges go for options. You can select options right here. Draw all edges, that's fine. Then black edge with one. Yes, and go for okay. Fine. Press okay. And then we have this.
Yeah. It's nice. And if we it's a good way, and your set UV to BMP files, and I can put all this inside.
Yes. Yep, close this window right here. And first I would go for a different name. Don't name your hangar Mesh 1. Do a right click. Rename, yes. And then name it to, I don't know. FF, yes. Hangar. Or Clubhaus, I would like. I thought it was a Clubhaus.
Und Benis line.
Okay, that's better. And you have right now what we did with UV map, we created a new material and a new texture on the bottom right here as well. I would name these to the same name like the object, because otherwise you will lost your materials or your texture file. Make a right click right there again. And rename it to FFF Clubhaus. Yes. Yes. And go down a little bit. No, the rest is not needed anymore because our object right now only has the FFF Clubhaus material. What I would do is delete all this, but it's a lot of clicking.
So you delete this and this and this and this?
Yes, that's from the object we got from SketchUp. But right now we did a new UV mapping and it sets up a new material as well. As I said at the beginning, we only need one material and one texture for one object.
Yeah, okay. Because at all this parts we have under here, it coming into Clubhaus BMP for and will put all these things in the right place.
Yes. You can delete all except FFF Clubhouse. It's a lot of clicking.
Yeah.
But that's what comes out of
Stone.
As well, something from SketchUp you can delete as well.
You can maybe make all.
No, you can't.
Ah, yep.
Yes, it's just right-click and delete, right-click and delete. I hate this very much, as objects come from different people. They send them to us and say like, oh, look at my plane. And then they have like this list of materials and I say, no, I don't want the plane. Also, Chris does the same sometimes as well.
Yeah.
Made a list of 1,000 materials which are not needed.
Mm.
You can just leave the default material, that's fine. Yes, that's good. That's good. Then leave this. Cool. We are deleting what SketchUp did wrong.
If you take it, hvis du slår den der samme image, kan du så slette dem alle sammen på én gang? Hvis du trykker det. Nej, det er nok, du skal nok lige trykke no herop. Og så collapse. Og så slet.
Bah. Yeah, we still have our FFF Clubhouse texture right there on the bottom. No, you can leave it for this right now, it's okay. But of course, to tidy up your work, I would delete them all. It's triple clicking. So now you need to go for the yes right here, and it's always plopping up on the bottom left. It's always a very long way.
Yeah. It's so complicated.
Yes, I say as well, but if you start right, it doesn't come to this point of messy file. Scroll down a little bit in the outliner right here, and on the bottom there's our texture which just has been created, the mesh 1 AUV. Rename this with a right click to FFFF Clubhouse as well.
Rename the button also.
Yes.
Yeah.
Of course. Ah. That is fast, Tim. Now do a right click on the FFFFF Clubhouse again, and you now need to make it external. Right now it's saved in. Oh, right now it's saved into the wings file, but we need it in an external like you have right here. Yes, exactly. FFFFF Clubhouse, FFFFF Clubhouse bitmap. You can change the file type right here. No, right now just go for a bitmap, that's fine. Then save is where you want to find it later as well.
Yeah, it's no problem, because it all these places that we have in the same map is put into the last bitmap files.
Okay. So then what Chris should do right now, if he gets this texture?
Yeah, okay.
Yes, do it right here. Open this texture in your it is your graphics thing.
Du skal bruge den har du ikke, Adobe Photoshop. Så skal du trykke der hvor den der hedder vælg en anden op. Flere apps nedenunder. Ja.
Oh, that seems to be a very old version of Adobe Photoshop.
Do it. This is the best Photoshop for many things.
Yeah, very nice.
Yeah.
What we have right now?
Zoom in. Yeah. Okay.
That's what Chris gets then. Yeah. What I normally do, we have this template right now. We don't need it for the actual texture later, so we just do it as a background. Do a double click right here to create a lark from the background layer. Yes, and name it to, I don't know, template or something.
Yeah.
Okay. And right now go for the mode right here. Make it to Merkere. And keep this template on the top. Every layer below will then you will have the black lines only on the top. If you save the file then later, just make the eye and it's gone. Okay, so now we need to get in our textures we already have to this files right here. Okay. I hope not.
I think that if you zoom in, you will not see this hole.
Maybe it's an artifact. Yes, I don't know.
If you press here and go to the hole point here, and you can see it's not open. Because this artifact line, it's very very small, and your screen will give you a small missing view. Yeah, no problem. Because if you zoom in, yeah,
pixel by pixel.
And okay. And we know it this small things it på dansk hedder de stjerne, ikke også? If you go up to this point, yeah, and put in the single of this, yeah, and now you can take this one, and you know can change to different color. Now only for this here, because this have det er jo stjernebrædder og alt det der. Så prøv at skifte til en brun farve et eller andet sted. Søn i den her.
Ah.
Dobbeltklik her. Ja. And you can turn to up and down here, so you can find the brown color. Yeah, nope. In the other felter. Dem her, dem maler vi bare. Ja. Højre klik på den der. Med musen. Tryk på højre klik. Hernede med skærmen. Ja. Ja. Stop. Vi åben her.
Yes, you now need to open the textures.
Ja, exakt. Open. And find the map. Oh, picture. Genau, der. So you can open lot of files on the same time if you like. Yeah, so you can take. Yeah, no problem. Du skal nok ind i den der klubhus, op i toppen. Op i toppen, dem der, det er bare blanding. Du skal ind i mappen, der hedder klubhus. Yes. Kontrol af. Yes, open. Now you have all small parts in the same. And you open this one. Yes. And now you can take example this one. Yeah. Press here. Yes. Control A. Let's go to have peel. Yes. Control C. Not exact this, maybe can do got in here større.
Yes, quite prøv lige at tryk, to remember which side is which one.
Ja, prøv lige at tryk control Z her. Ja. Take tryllestaven. Yes. Og så markere den der nede. Yes. Control V. So we so you have control A R T. Yes. Move. Du kan zoom ind, så du bedre kan se. Anvend.
It needs to be slightly out of the black edge. So just one pixel on the left side, then it's fine. That's why we left a little bit of space between them.
Det går ikke noget, det rager lidt udenfor.
Yes. Ja.
That's det der fine. Udenfor, det der udenfor kommer ikke med, så det er jo fint nok. Enter for at låse. Ja. Så er den låst.
You move the lark one down right now, then you would see the black above it. Perfect. The black line right here, it's above this lark within. Or this was above the black line.
Yeah. But it's
fine, yes. Very good.
If you take this place. You can take this here. I think it's the same. Control A, Control C. Control V. Kan du bare bruge på? Ja, ja, okay. Jo. Ja, og så Control. Nej, du har den der huller i den, så. Det kan du ikke gøre noget ved lige nu. Du kan bare, det er lige meget. bare sige Ctrl V. So big one. Så skal vi lige zoome helt ud. Ja. Så tager du den der over. Starter udenfor. Der. Og så bare på tværs. Nu er den væk alt sammen. Ja, ja, okay. Ctrl V. Det er jo very big picture. Ctrl T. Så må du mose den ned ved at skalere nedad. Du skal holde Ctrl-tasten ned samtidig. Så holder den skalaen. Eller er det shift, det kan jeg ikke lige huske. Shift. Sådan, nu holder den skalaen. Der. Op der. Så shift ned samtidig med, at du trækker. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Så. Move. Ja. Altid. Vi ved jo, at de der, de passer. Zoom ind, så du kan se. Enter. Ja. Zoom ind. Og så kan du Ctrl T igen. Jo, jo. Du... Ja, det er fint. Ja, det er fint. Og så over fra den anden side også der. Der kan du bare ikke komme ud over. Det kan du der. Så skal den lige en anelse op her. Billedet bliver skarpt, når du trykker enter. Ja, så so nice. Du har lidt hvid der. Så Ctrl T igen. Ja, yeah, it's right. Og det vil give white color en kondor. Ctrl. Ah, det er et nedløbsrør, så det er fint. Yes, it's yeah. Safe.
Yeah, first what I wanted to say, deselect the black thing again, black template on the eye-white here, because otherwise on the edges of our object we would get these black lines as well.
Yeah, save.
You can save right now, yes.
No, but... No, not this. Ja, okay. Prøv lige at... Ja. Og så... No.
Vi har også bitmap as well, so we can get it.
Jeg skal gemme som BMP også. Den der, det er bare for, at vi kan arbejde videre bagefter. Yes.
Oh, it's fine.
No.
Rename it.
Rename it. Copy back. Google. Og mellemrummet også. Så. So. Okay. Yeah, no problem.
I think. I don't know if you have any.
No problem, because we have saved the picture.
Yes, okay. That's good. Yep, 24 bits.
Yeah, or 24 is best.
32 nope. Would be with alpha channel. We don't have alpha channel right here, or don't need one. So go for 24 bit. Yes.
Must be. If they are different, you will fall missing in Condor.
Now, as you rename the texture, you need to import it again. That can be done here on File. Then import image. Now search for the file we just created. I think it was right here in this folder. Open. And now we need to move the new test bitmap onto our material. So grab this one here and with drag and drop move it up to the material on the top. This, yes. Then diffuse texture. There we go. Yep. See if we have our side, middle mouse. There it is.
Yeah. But at some part of the building is the over, under zero. I see. Not in level.
Yes, that's right.
That's good.
There are some new more things right now. Select the wall object again. Hoppala. So in object mode, the wall object, yes. And then make a right click on the FFF clubhouse material and assign the material to the selection. Okay. Yes, now it's better. Because it has it had multiple materials before. Right now, this glucose material. Yes, you can deselect again. Then we can see it. Yes, that's what it looks like.
That's good.
So there are just a few more things to do. Press right now. It's not shaded. You can select this one here on the top right. Then you can shade the object like it would look in Condor.
Mm.
You see right now this fades right here from white to black.
Yeah.
This is because Condor or Wings right now wants to try to make this here round corner right here as well. You understand that a little bit? Yes, exactly. What you just can do for your objects, I would say, go for the object mode. Select the wall object. So, yes, go for right click. Do auto smooth. Yeah, deselect again, and you see it looks a little bit better now. Even when it's shaded, because go to the unshaded mode again, and you will see the edges will turn yellow right now.
Mm.
So the yellow parts define the hard edges. Okay, if you go to line mode right now.
Du skal flytte musen hen og så tryk på højre musetast.
Yes, and now go for right click.
Yeah.
And make hardness. Then to soft again.
Soft? Ah, okay.
Or invert, whatever you like. You can only define between hard or soft edge. And deselect again and go to shade mode. Then you will see the difference.
Ah.
Yes, nice. Condor tries, Wings tries to do a round edge right here.
Yeah.
Doesn't work nice because it's not a round edge, of course.
Yeah. Tim, er løsningen ikke, at du får bygget dem der, sådan at vi har en BMP med alle pladerne, og så skal jeg nok udfylde, nu for eksempel som du kalder den her FFF. Jo. Ja, jeg skal lige nemlig noget nu her, så jeg er helt enig. Ja, det er en aftale. Hej hej. User disconnected from your channel.
Yes, that's right. Somewhere in the texture. It's okay. You see what needs to be done. I think the hangar needs to be moved a little bit up to get it onto the Zero. Because right now it would stick in the ground in Condor. Right click in the window right here. Yeah, it is. Yep. That's a little bit of a problem right now, because if you are in object mode, we only have the center of the object, you know, the geometry center of it. You can't really see the can't really set it to zero right now. What you can do is like what you did right now. Yes, that's fine. But in that case, right now you have a perspective view. If you go right here, you have an orthographical view on the top right. Just make a right click, yes. This one. And then you can set it to zero by eye. Yeah, maybe do it a little bit more down, then you are safe. Okay, when it's a little bit in the ground. Yep, that's fine. You want to see where it is right now? Yes. Or the x-axis, I'm not sure. I think it's the x one. The blue one is the z one. That's fine. You want to see on which altitude your bottom face is right now? Then deselect the object and go to face mode. And only select the bottom face. Yes. Go for a right click, then look at absolute comments, then move, and there you can see the yes, that's fine. Centimeters in the round, that's good. All we need. Yes, that's fine. It should be okay with 0, 0, 0 as well. Oh, it's good. Good to go right here. Yeah. That's it what you need to do in Wings and Photoshop. Right now, if you want to get it into Condor, yeah, make this edge here a hard edge again. No, we need to do a right click right here. Then go for hardness. Make it hard. Yes. Better. Yeah, you really need to keep your left hand on the keys, because it's very important while there. As well, the A function, like selecting a face and then go for pressing A on your, or alpha on your keyboard, very useful. Work with both hands. Oh, okay. Okay, fine. Yeah, would be getting this into Condor. First, I would save this file. Yes, that's a good idea. Save as FFF.
FFF Clubhus. I don't know. Whatever you like.
Now we need to get it into Condor. Yes, need to export it as OBJ, and then one group per material must be ticked. Fine, triangulated must be ticked. Web XSS we don't need it. Export normal and smoothing groups must be ticked. Export UV maps must be ticked, and default texture type can be changed to bitmap. Yes, and then press OK. Export it as FFFFFGroupos. Very good. Now jump. We have the landscape editor. Okay, so now we need to first save it as 3D object. Then we can place it in the landscape editor. Yes, do we have the Denmark landscape as well? Okay. Oh, besides, you can go into the object viewer. First, let it load. Jo. Yes. To drop it into the. But you need only the C3D file, you don't need the object file for Condor. So you should first go into the object viewer. But that is something Finn knows as well. It was quite fast there. I have no idea about the shape editor, what you can do. Yes. This go for file,
open OBJ, select your FFF tuples,
correct one. Is it correct? No, it is not. Old one. Shouldn't it be in the FFF Clubhus? Yeah, that's it. Very good. Okay. Yepa. Now, on the top left, you can see the statistics of it, and the texture path must be correct within your landscape folder. So you need to start with landscapes. Then backslash Denmark 5, backslash, I don't know, airports, backslash FFF Clubhouse test.bmp, wherever you put it, you're okay. So first put the texture somewhere and then the path right there. No problem. I like this mouse pointer. I would put it somewhere into AirPods, maybe. Ah, you don't have the FFF. Yeah. I then go back and go for the world and textures folder then into FFFFF groups. Yes. Now it's okay, put it in here. No. Oh, nice watch. Oh yeah, there was the watch. There it is. Who's this? Yes. Go to the It int. Very good. So we now need this path right here. Up to landscape. Java. There. Backslash. Well, I think it's Alt GR and your question mark. Copy as well, yes. Okay, fine. Right now, save it as the folder.
Your color.
Apes. Must be in the object then. Right. We don't have a. Yeah, for now it's okay. Little bit messy right here. Okay, you can close it here and place it in landscape editor and hopefully we see it then in FFFFF. Yes, reload different, I think what Finn did, always switch to Reunion and then switch back to Denmark. Was able to see it somehow. I don't know. Never used this. Oh, it's getting late. Look. Take a shower. Yes, but I want to see if it works. Fine, I have time at least. I think with this thing in here. Move it, yes. Way poor. I don't know. Where is FFFFF? Denmark 5. I don't know. It's not the mouse wheel. Then go, maybe try a right or left click. Don't know, never use this. Yeah, it's okay. Maybe it's about it's because map projection, maybe. I don't know. Coordinates must be right. I think. I just place it somewhere there. Yes.
We need to go for ground objects.
We are able to get it here. FFF Clubhouse. Oops. I really have no idea.
I should maybe jump in into this someday.
Okay. Yeah, I think so. Okay, and I think it works right now. Let's have a look. The best game ever. Very good answer. Task yesterday evening only plays 5 for me. Oh, but it's fine. Oh, yeah. Chance to get away right there. Leave of sleep, but. Yes. Very good. Let's see. That works. Beautiful game. Problem, same for no, that would be too expensive. No, it would be too expensive. Yes, everybody has it to assist. Join, yes. very fine. What we need. Very good. Yes. But that's okay. The effort will be rewarded someday. Yes, of course, no problem, Tim. Happy that. Yeah, no problem. Look quiet. Yes, that's fine. Everybody can learn from it. Can redo it, but I think.